Hello there. Let's continue training our AI to see chessboards in images and videos. In this video, we'll make a better quality synthetic dataset using Blender and train a YOLO model in TensorFlow with it. I'm especially excited to train piece detection on it too. In the previous videos, we went from classical computer vision approaches to a machine learning model trained on virtual images I made using Blender, off a simple chessboard at different angles with some cylinders on it as pieces. This worked surprisingly well, despite the board and pieces looking different from the real chessboards, though probably as a result, it struggled with finding boards in several images that were too different in style or color, or at weird angles, or perhaps randomly placed cylinders aren't a perfect analog to chess pieces in a real game. A ML model needs good quality training data, and in this case, that means images that look similar to the real images we'll be using the model on. It also means we need good labels, the thing the model is trying to predict. Here, that is currently the class ID and bounding box of the chessboard, which we can define as an integer and the pixel coordinates of the box. You might be like me and looking at these videos and thinking, hey, could it detect chess pieces too? That would be really cool. But I don't have any pieces labeled in my dataset yet. Since we're aspiring here, I want to make this dataset useful for ideas like finding pieces too, so we'll include the class IDs and bounding boxes of those as well. I want to do image segmentation as well, so let's add a segmentation mask image, where each pixel is the class ID of the object in view. I don't have any plans for how I'll use all of these labels yet, but perhaps future Sam, or one of you watching, will have an idea. Let me know in the comments. I could try to hand label images, and in fact I did try, but it took a while to label around 30 images with just a chessboard bounding box. Don't even get me started on trying to draw out the boxes and segmentation polygon masks for the pieces too. I went ahead and ran this through a simple augmentation pipeline on Roboflow and trained an object detection model with those 30 images.
2 hours later.
And it did kind of work, but it couldn't find chessboards on many of the same images that our previous model trained on the synthetic data was able to find, likely because there isn't enough varied data. Just for fun, I also tried to train it on the pieces, and that failed horribly as well. We need way more data for the pieces. If we wanted the highest quality dataset, we'd likely need to spend money to acquire and hand label real images of a large variety of chessboards in different lighting conditions and places until we had a couple thousand labeled images. Perhaps we'll save that for another time. Since the synthetic approach seems promising, let's make better quality models of multiple chessboards, and also model the actual chess pieces and place them on the board in ways that resemble real chess games. For labeling, let's cover all of the bases. In addition to the chessboard bounding box, we'll also get the four corners of the chessboard and the bounding box and class labels for all of the pieces. Let's also add in the camera matrix, and while we're at it, let's get a pixel level segmentation mask for the whole image too. This is a bit overkill right now, but it means we'll be able to try different kinds of machine learning approaches on this dataset in future videos, things like UNet segmentation, four corner detections, piece detection, and more. We'll need to do a little geometry maths to get all of this information, but I think it's kind of interesting and often useful to learn how these kind of datasets are made and used for machine learning. This kind of knowledge applies to most ML or robotics problems out there. Let's get right into it. Let's open up Blender and start making a chessboard. I'm new to Blender, but it's quite beginner friendly, so don't be too intimidated if you haven't used it before. I look up the dimensions of a Staunton tournament chessboard that looks pretty similar to the boards I've often seen in videos of chess competitions. I'll use these images as references in Blender, bringing everything to a scale of 5 cm a chess tile. Then, I want to get that wood inset, so I make a programmatic wood texture. I have another video where I go into detail about modeling a chessboard and making these textures. I'll link it above for those interested. This looks pretty good, I like that. I look at it from different angles and it seems pretty similar to the images. I also go ahead and make a couple of variations of other common chessboards. We can randomly choose one of these chessboards for each image when we're generating our dataset. Now for the fun part, let's make the pieces. Last time I just made cylinders, this time I'd like to try to make something closer to the tournament set. So let's pull in a reference image of the side profiles of the chess pieces and start with the pawn since it's the easiest one. There are several approaches we could do, but I'll go with tracing the side profile, then revolving it and converting it to a mesh. This works for the radially symmetric portions of most of the pieces. I add some crenulations to the rook. I don't know about you, but I used to call it a castle. The knight is a bit more complicated, and my beginner abilities definitely show here. But I eventually get it made. For the bishop, I can subtract out a cube to get that slot added. The king and queen are mostly symmetric, with a little crown wiggle for the queen and a cross added on top for the king. With the meshes all done, we add some simple black and white materials with colors from the references. At some point, we can make these materials more plasticky, but it looks good enough for now. Alright, this looks pretty great. Let's get the pieces on the board. Since the board has 5cm tiles, we can use a bit of simple math to get the center of each tile for spawning a new piece. In the past video, I just randomly placed cylinders on tiles with no plan. This time, I'd like to lay out the pieces on the board to not only look like real games, but actually be from real games. For a while now, chess matches have been stored in a standardized portable game notation or PGN format, and we can download a bunch of Masters matches from the past. Once we load that in, we can choose a random game, and then a random position in that game and place the pieces based on that. The process for getting these layouts is a fun little project of its own. Let me know in the comments if you'd like to know more about that. I may make a video on that if people are interested. Now we have a chessboard in pieces. If we render an image, this looks pretty awesome. I'm very happy with this, but this by itself isn't enough for a good dataset, since we still need to get the labels, and we might as well put it into a standard format that ML models can understand. One of the simpler ones is the original YOLO Darknet format, which is a simple text file for each image. In the text file, each row contains a series of numbers. The first is the class ID, and the next four are the bounding box coordinates, which we'll do as X, Y, width, and height for each bounding box. The Darknet text file doesn't provide a way to store segmentations, so we'll also save our annotations in the most common format for models these days, COCO. The COCO format's a JSON file used for most major computer vision competition datasets, with lots of extra annotation information, such as segmentation, which is stored as a series of polygon XY coordinates. Calculating the bounding box and segmentation polygons for the board and pieces is a good bit of maths that could take up a video of its own, but the basic idea is we take all of the points of our objects, project it to our camera image plane, and then fit a convex hull or bounding box to these points. We also use Blender to generate and store a segmentation mask image that gives per pixel class labels. There are probably better ways to do this, but I found the Blender object ID mapping nodes work just fine to make these images. And with that, we have a single image with annotations. Each of these images are the bricks that will build our high quality dataset building. I'm really excited about this. Unlike bricks, we actually want to randomize every image we generate. So we'll place a camera in a random position looking at the board. We'll also randomly move the light around and change its intensity and color temperature also. Finally, we'll randomly choose a different board from the collection of boards I made, and also choose a random board layout of pieces from one of the Masters games. Let's try running this a few times. Hey, I'm really happy with that. I am loving the shadows and lighting we're getting from the ray tracing from the Blender Cycles engine. That wood texture, the specular highlights, it looks very realistic. If these images weren't floating in the air, I might think some of them look like real chessboards at first. In the last video, I added random backgrounds in the augmentation process directly. And while that is probably the best way to do it, it adds a lot of extra complexity to the training process and makes it hard to compare with different models or Roboflow or whatever. I'd like to have a single dataset I try different approaches with. So let's create a separate script to generate a dataset with baked-in random backgrounds. Alright, perfect. Let's generate around 2,000 images. While it's doing that, I'll try to hand label some images too. After about 20 minutes, I finished 3 images by hand, and it's already done. This would have taken me a month, but instead, after a quick tea break, we're back and ready to go. Let's load the dataset and have a look at a couple of the images and annotations. Great, the annotations loaded up properly. As a first go, we'll do just board detection, like in the part 2 video, and see if we've improved any. We'll add several image augmentations like color, crops, and also cut out random parts of the images, which will sort of emulate things like blocking the view. These augmentations will randomly apply during training and help the model generalize instead of overfit. This looks good. Some of these images are pretty difficult for me too, so I hope the little model doesn't get too discouraged. Let's train it for around 20 epochs, and evaluate it on unseen images from the test dataset. The green box is the ground truth bounding box of the chessboard in the image, and the yellow boxes are the predictions. Look at that, it's starting to find the board! I'm excited to see how it'll do on real images. Whoa, it's doing a really good job! Alright, moment of truth. Let's see how it does on some videos compared to the old model. Yes! It's so much better! Even though our training dataset was all synthetic images, and a single chessboard per image, the model is able to find chessboards it's never seen on real images, and even multiple chessboards in images. And it's doing a lot better than our previous synthetic dataset. So cool. Okay, I'm itching to try it on pieces too now. We'll modify the script to include the piece bounding boxes. I did try it with all the piece labels, but the model was struggling to convert, so perhaps I'll try that again another time. Instead, we'll simplify the problem to just three classes: a chessboard, white pieces, and black pieces. And it's starting to converge. Let's run it on some videos and see how it does. Whoa, this is so cool. It's doing a pretty decent job of detecting pieces on the board, and even off of the board too. It's not perfect. It's mistaking white and black pieces and missing several of them pretty often. This is a pretty hard problem. Because the model is having to learn to find the pieces, it gets a bit worse at finding some of the chessboards, so there is a bit of a trade-off here. I think there are several ways to sort of optimize down this path. If we really constrain the types of videos and boards, you could build a model that performs much better for that one in particular, but that doesn't sound as exciting to me for now. For completeness, let's use the approach from the previous video of cropping the chessboard bounding boxes and running our classical computer vision algorithm to find the precise board corners and see how it does. Yes! This is so awesome! Look at that! It's finding the boards in really difficult scenes like in this bar, where there's tons of things going on, the camera's moving all over the place, cutting off the boards at the edges of the screen or zooming in and out. Ah, this is so cool. Our algorithm runs on each frame as completely independent images. There's no prior or outside knowledge. How cool is that? The model is completely trained on synthetic data, having never seen a real-life chessboard or pieces, and it still works. The boxes and outline jitter as a result of it working on independent image frames. And while I won't get into it in this video, something like a Lucas Kanade optical flow tracker between frames would smooth this out and make it much more stable and faster to process too. These results are really exciting and show that this sort of dataset will be a great base for trying different custom models. We've looked at two approaches now, computer vision only and YOLO plus computer vision. We finally have the tools to try and build a better custom model, so in the next video, we'll explore that. I think some interesting directions include UNet segmentations, corner heat maps, and something I heard about recently that's used for human pose detection, convolutional pose machines. I'm really interested to explore this space and share it with you all. I can't wait to show you where we go from here. If you enjoyed watching this video, it'd mean a lot to me if you left a like, and make sure to subscribe so you can watch the next video in the series. Let me know in the comments if you'd like to know more about different parts of this video. There was quite a lot to cover, so we did go quickly. Anyway, I should probably let my computer cool down now. Trading models has had the computer fan going pretty hard, and the room has gotten pretty warm now. I guess this'll come in handy since winter is coming. Cheers!